It's 12 o'clock.
Attention, citizens. It's time for the witching hour.
Welcome to week three of the Witching Hour, and it's my birthday! Yeah, right! I'm really fucking excited about this. We got a great cake. Now, this is a special cake that I make for special events. I used to make it for a party called the Barbecue of Blood. And it used to be called the abortion cake, but my wife doesn't like the word the abortion cake. So I'm going to change the name of the abortion cake to Happy Fun My Little Pony Cake. How's that? That make you happy, honey? All right, great. It's no longer the abortion cake. It's Happy Fun My Little Pony Magic Cake. All right, and it is my birthday. Yeah! And so we're going to celebrate. Now, unfortunately, our first guest couldn't be here. This seems to be like a running thing, like Colleen White couldn't be here and my first guest couldn't be here because he's sick. And I feel really bad for him, but I definitely have him on another show. He's one of my best friends in the world. So we're going to go to a tape of something. Every year for my birthday, I get a tattoo. And so this is going to be a tape of me going to Boston Tattoo Company and getting a tattoo. And you're going to meet a really bunch of cool people. So let's go to the tape and happy birthday! Hey, here I am at Boston Tattoo Company. I'm going to get a tattoo.
Hey, this is Elise.
Hi.
You're going to be on my TV show.
Oh, yes. Right, here you go. Check them out.
Nice.
Cute. Do you like them?
I love it.
Cool.
We'll be right back.
All right. How do you feel, Ryan?
Great. Actually, awesome.
Elise, how do you feel?
I feel fine.
All right.
Feeling good.
Awesome. This is Elise.
Hi.
And she's fucking awesome.
Oh, stop you.
Hey, and we're back. I hope you liked that as much as I did. All right. So, oh man, I'm so excited about our next guest. Our next guest is an actor. He was in the movie Easy Rider, and he was also in one of my favorite horror movie of all time, Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2, and you can see the shirt. I'm wearing it just for him. I'm all excited about it, and I can't believe he's going to be here. This is so fantastic on my birthday. Please welcome Dennis Hopper, everybody! Dennis Hopper, woo!
Ryan.
Yeah?
He's dead.
What?
Yeah,
no!
He's dead.
No, not again! No! No! Oh, this sucks. It never ends. Well, man, this is what happens when you book people a year in advance. Somebody always dies. All right. Well, I'm going to go to our next guest. I'm really excited to have them on. Our next guest is fantastic. I just can't believe that they're here. They're a huge group of people, and they're going to do some wild, crazy stuff. And please welcome Lydia's Carnival Sideshow! Right on! Woo!
Okay. Ryan, thank you for having us on. We appreciate it. My name is Tony Ganji, better known as the Amazing Human Head. I'm the proprietor of Lydia's Carnival Sideshow. I do have two performers with me here today and a few other people that are looking forward to talking about the sideshow. But first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with a little sword swallowing. If you can help me, if I could get a little volunteer, or tall volunteer, stand right over here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually be swallowing a blade that's probably about 18 inches long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to swallow it right down my throat. It'll go through my oral pharynx first. That's the rear of the mouth to you and me. It'll go down into the esophagus. Now, if the sword was a little longer, it would actually drop into my stomach, but it's actually not that long, so it won't be dropping into my stomach. So what I'm going to do is after I swallow the sword, I'm actually going to bend my body in half. You're going to take the hilt, pull it straight out. Don't do this, and don't do this, okay? Got it?
Yep.
All right. Okay, now, the sword we're going to be using today is this one right here. All right, it's not actually as long as it seemed, but like most things. All right, here we go. Rules remain the same. Here we go. All right, now, I know. That's not real impressive, is it? It's not. I know. You could admit it. All right. However, if the hole that this was going into was relative in size to the sword, that would be an impressive feat, don't you think? Luckily, you and I and everybody else has a hole that's relative in size to this sword. It's not the one you're thinking of. This is not a demonstration of sword swallowing. It is a demonstration of something called the human blockhead. Rules remain the same. Melvin Burkhardt made this act famous, and it was Robert Ripley who, when he saw Melvin Burkhardt hammer a nail into his head, he said, "Melvin, you are a human blockhead." Thank you very much. Now, have you ever been fishing? Do you know what the main rule in fishing is?
No.
No? The main rule in fishing is always, always eat what you catch. Thank you very much. as I said, I do have two performers with me here today. The first performer we have is the East Massachusetts Rudder Girl, better known as Deneen Ludwig. Please give her a big round of applause.
Thank you, Tony. All right, as Tony said, I am considered the East Massachusetts Rubber Girl. This is because, just like rubber, I am able to bend in lots of fun and funny positions. When I was younger, I found out I was able to actually pop my elbows in and out of their sockets, as well as I was able to dislocate my shoulders. Now for my trick, I'm also going to need two helpers, so one and two. All right. Mm-hmm. Now what I need you guys to do, you guys got to follow me very simply, okay? You're going to be first. All right, hold my hand, both hands. Now I'm going to need you to turn it that way. Go ahead. Don't be afraid. I do this all the time. You're good. Keep going. What are you doing? All right, stop. Now I need you to do the same thing that way. Keep going. And, oh, you're holding my wrist. Thank you. And stop. Now what I need you guys to do is let go. Tingly. Now, thank you guys. I'm set with you guys. The way I'm able to do this is I found out I'm able to actually, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it, I can actually pop my shoulder, you can actually see in here, in and out of its socket at will. I hope you can see that. If not, come to the show. You'll see it.
And that was Deneen Ludwig, the East Massachusetts Rubber Girl. Please give her a big round of applause. Now, Lydia's Carnival Sideshow takes place right now at Life and Death, the third Saturday of every month. As I do every month, I always like to recite a little poem for my mom. This is called Mother by the Amazing Human Head. When I was a boy, naive and young, my mother taught me to beware of my tongue. Be careful, she said, it can cut like a knife, cause sadness and anger, depression and strife. With friends at a game, my tongue lashed out quick, the words poured forth, oily and slick. How is it mothers know when your behavior is poor? For when I returned home, she was there, at the door. My mother did not believe in washing mouths out with soap. That was a punishment for which I could only hope. Instead, retribution came with a loud snap, from metal and wood in the form of this trap. I still do it today, though it leaves my tongue sore. I'll tell you why as I said it and do it once more. You see, in this wide world, through the turbulent and the calm, the trap's the one thing that reminds me of mom. Now with us today is the queen of gyrations, Nicole Sanders. Nicole Sanders is a hula hooper and an amazing hula hooper at that. I don't know if we can turn off the lights in the studio. She does have her LED hoop and it's a really amazing thing to see. So please give Nicole Sanders a big round of applause.
Thank you.
And that was Nicole Sanders, the Queen of Gyrations. Give her another big round of applause. And let me wrap up the performance section of our show with the way this act was traditionally done by Melvin Burkhart. Melvin, of course, had a much larger hammer, and he had a much larger nail than the one I'm using today. Melvin's was probably about the size of a railroad spike. But the traditional way this is done is this way. Always like to sterilize the nail first. And that is the human lock. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, Lydia's Carnival Sideshow. We do have a couple more performers here that we're going to, Ryan will be happy to interview along with ourselves. Thank you very much.
Over here. That's what we're going to do. Let's get everybody up, all the performers up in the group. And then we're going to go down the line and everybody introduce themselves and what they do again. And then we'll talk.
Tony Ganji, the better known as the Amazing Human Head. I'm the human blockhead, as well as mastering animal traps. I stick various appendages into animal traps, including my tongue and my hands.
I'm Denine Ludwig, also known as the Eastern Massachusetts Rubber Girl, also a contortionist. And that just means I bend my body into really funny shapes, and I can also fit inside of very small areas.
Nicole Sanders, I'm the Queen of Gyration, and I play with hula hoops.
Hi, my name is Jimmy Hafted, and I will be laying on a bed of nails.
Nice.
And I'm Donna Purnell. I'm Alexandria the Great, Queen of Extreme, and I am an escape artist.
I'm Dave Bartwell, and I'm the purveyor of oddities. I will show you some strange things from my collection.
Oh, cool. Who is the leader of the group? All right, you're the leader. How did you get started?
I came out with a book in March called Carney Sideshows, Weird Wonders of the Midway, put out by Citadel Press. And while I was on a brief book tour, it got into my head that, you know, it might be a good idea to put together a sideshow with a variety of different acts and maybe try and mount it in Salem. So it started looking at venues in September 2010, and our first preview night was in December 2010, and then our first show was in January 2011.
Cool. How did you get involved?
Well, I've always been able to do crazy stuff, like put my legs behind my head and do back bends and stuff when I was little, and I kind of turned it into being able to work with my arms, and I got introduced to Tony through a mutual friend of ours. Tony found out that I was a contortionist. He approached me and he was like, hey, can I stick you in a basket full of swords? And I was like, yeah, and it's been wonderful ever since.
That's awesome. And are you still working over at Nightmare Factory?
Actually, no, I've actually moved to Freight Kingdom in Nashua, New Hampshire.
Oh, Freight Kingdom, I know Freight Kingdom, yeah, Tim.
I'm the manager of the Psycho Circus up there.
Oh, no kidding, I didn't know that, I was up there this year.
I probably scared you. Wait, you came through with the Nightmare Gallery guy.
Yes.
I was the crazy clown with the pink hair who came out and scared Kelly.
Nice job. You guys were awesome. I love that clown place, man, because it has elements of the Cirque from Foxborough, which was my home for 1 year. Now, I worked for Spooky World for 10 or 12 years or something like that, starting in Berlin and went all the way to the Bayside, where I was manager of the experiment. So it's nice to have haunt people involved as well. But I love Freight Kingdom. We had a really great time. You guys put on a great show, everybody.
I'm glad I was able to scare you guys.
Now, how did you get involved in... that was fantastic.
Thank you. I actually went to a concert once, and they were mainly for their stage performance. And one of the girls was a fire hula hooper, and I saw it, and I was like, I want to do that. So I went to some gatherings, learned some things. I told Neen that I played with fire. She and hula hooped. She told Tony, Tony got a hold of me, and that's where it started.
Oh, cool, cool, cool. And so you lay on nails. Awesome. How did you get started doing that?
Well, I was her assistant.
Oh, you're assistant. Assistant
for a couple of shows, and I just wanted to try the bed of nails, and now I'm doing that.
Oh, cool, cool. And that's your gig for now. But then, are you moving up to other things like that?
Whatever comes my way, whatever Tony.
Whatever horrible things I want to do. That's awesome. I know some other Sideshow folks, Seth Carney.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah,
Wick.
Good. Yep.
You know
yeah.
Wick?
Yeah, I know Wick. Wick's a sweet girl person.
That's
and
funny.
So, always fun. now, I talked to you first through email. Come right over here. Don't be afraid. I talked to you first through email because I saw that you do escape. Tricks.
I do. And they're not tricks.
Sorry. So what do you call them? They're escape.
What are escapes?
I'm mistress of escapology, shall we say.
And the female Houdini,
yes.
I saw.
Yes.
And now you're not in the Guinness Book of World Records?
No, but I am in the URDB, which is another record holder.
Oh, cool.
Brand. So they actually came to New York. I did an extreme straitjacket for them, and I did it for Fox National News. And it was a regulation straitjacket with 50 feet of chain and 10 padlocks, and I hold the record for it.
Really?
I did it in 2 minutes and 37 seconds.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Really
pretty
cool.
Good. Yeah. So right now I'm actually with the Sideshow, and I actually unveiled the underwater cell, which we like to call UC, which very different from other escape artists. We call it UC because you see everything. So it's a clear tank.
Wow.
And so you can see it all.
Wow,
so,
that's really cool.
Yeah.
And now, isn't that how Houdini died?
In the water torture cell,
yeah.
Yes, but
yeah.
Mine's a cube. So,
oh, all right.
You know, I do pay homage to Houdini,
oh, cool. Yeah.
But I actually try to go beyond Houdini and, you know, taking a straitjacket and adding to it, or taking his water torture cell and making it something different. Mine is smaller. It's only 36 by 30, I believe, or 24. So
oh.
It's a very, so it literally is
wow.
A cube.
Then
mm-hmm.
folks like putting mm-hmm. yourself in
yeah.
some of that stuff too.
Yeah.
Putting
so.
Things out of dislocating things and things around
mm-hmm.
and things
so,
like that.
Yep, and what I'm gonna do for
March
the next
19th.
Show is March 18th.
March
19th. 19th. March 19th.
Okay.
Saturday night.
It's April.
No.
It's April. Yes, okay.
I'm going to do something that we call airless. So it's it's actually a chain straitjacket with a handy wrap around my
face.
That's
so
awesome. I can
How did it work out? Was it a really good show?
Yes.
All right. But anyways, so that's cool. And then how did you find, like, you wanted, that was what you wanted to do? I'm going to be an escapist? Is that the...
Yeah, you can. Yeah.
Escapist?
Yeah. Well, actually...
I like to escape, too, occasionally,
yeah,
but
I
different
do.
Ways.
I can do it in many different ways. No, actually, you know, I do have a love for Houdini, and
mm.
I just thought that this was, you know, something that needed to be... you know, out there, and, you know, a lot of people do what Houdini did, and if you know anything about him, he really didn't like people who copied. He wanted something different, so that's why I said, you know what, I'd like to try and go beyond Houdini and bring the art form back, because, number one, there aren't many women that are doing this.
No.
And it's mostly a male population, and, you know, I actually felt that, you know, being a woman and doing something extraordinary was something that we really needed, and that, you know, I think has a message for other women out there that,
yeah,
you know, hopefully I can inspire people, and that's what I'd like to do. I'd like
cool.
to go and, you know, mind over matter, if you don't mind. It doesn't
yeah.
matter.
That's awesome.
So.
Come right over here, and we'll talk
sure.
about your, now you have oddities.
Yes.
Like,
name a few things.
Medical anomalies.
Oh, cool.
Unusual artifacts and curios.
Oh, cool. Did it start out as a collecting thing? You started collecting and then...
Actually, it did. The story is, when Tony had moved into town, I found out that there was somebody doing sideshow work, and I had always loved the art of sideshow work and the different oddities that may be presented to you, and I've always collected unusual things. So Tony and I got together, we started talking, and I started showing some of the items from my collection, and we kind of grooved on a little bit,
okay.
And it went from there.
That's awesome. And do you have a permanent display someplace as well, or you just take it on the road?
No, it's in my man cave, my loft.
Nice.
Where the oddities are. I got forced out of the living space by my wife.
Nice. It got too unusual,
and it moved out there, and it just started growing, and it exploded. I mean, it started when I was very young.
Cool.
And I was lucky enough to actually see a 10-in-1 sideshow. And see some things in the mid-70s. If you do the math, you can figure out my age.
I'm 27 today.
Yeah.
That's really cool. Now I'm going to invite you guys to go visit my friend James next door. He's going to be on later in the season at the Nightmare Gallery. He's just opening, opened a month ago.
Yes.
but if you haven't been to Nightmare Gallery before, you would love it.
Oh, James is a great guy.
Yeah, he's a great guy.
Really
good friend. Now, do you own, are you a part owner of Life and Death Tours, or are you just...
No, not at all. Life and Death Tours, Life and Death is a morbid gift shop over in the Museum Place Mall.
Right.
And every September and October, they have Vlad and Dan Greenwolf do a magic show there.
Cool.
And it was Vlad that kind of said, you know, in the off season, you might want to try and do the sideshow there. So we looked at the space, and it seems to be working right now. But we are going to end up having to find a new home at some point.
Oh, cool.
So anybody knows a place out there, we're looking for
nice.
A home.
Nicole's going to be on a later show. So
very cool. Very cool.
Yeah. I like to support the local shops and the people that are groovy and doing it.
She's a great person, and she's got some really unusual stuff in that shop.
And Life and Death is like sort of partnered with Nightmare Gallery. I work for Nightmare Gallery now because I can walk to work instead of like driving for 2 hours to get to my place where I scare the crap out of people for a living. And I really love it over there. But I love Salem. I love people who are involved in Salem and the stuff that goes on in there. So I'm really glad that you guys are doing stuff, and I hope it works out well for you guys.
I think that was one of the things, like when I started this, everybody said this, something like this won't work outside of September and October in Salem, and we were happy to prove them wrong, because January and February shows were sold out, standing room only.
I heard that.
So we're very happy that the people of Salem are happy with it.
And I know the person who does the art for your website, Chad.
Chad is a great guy. Yeah,
he
did a wonderful piece of artwork for us. Yeah.
He works for us. He has created an Angelica Houston from The Witches.
That's right. Yep.
It's going to debut fairly soon. Well, it should already be there behind this show. it's tough, like living in the present and future. I'm a time traveler.
You're a time lord. That's what you
That's
are.
Right.
You're a time lord.
The TARDIS is up back.
That's right.
Ready to go. Well, that's awesome. Well, thank you everybody for coming on the show, and
thanks for having
thanks.
Us.
Thank you.
You guys are welcome anytime.
Thank you. LydiasCarnivalSideshow.com if people want information about the show.
LydiasCarnivalSideshow.com. Please, and see Chad's work too.
It's on there.
Yeah,
that's really great.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I don't break laws. I make laws. I'm the lawmaker. I'm the one that lays the track down. We'll be right back.
Guest I'm so fucking excited about. Our next guest is a performer who performs at Jacques, and I am so excited about this. And I there's not enough that I could say. I am really so happy. Please welcome Ms. Fena Barbitall! Woo! Yeah, baby!
Trying to survive. I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire, it's my empire. And yes, I call the shots, I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water upon the vampire. Yeah. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I'm Goliath with the sling. This very moment, I bring. Put it on everything that I will retire with the ring. And I will retire with the crown.
Yes.
No, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed.
Yes.
Clap for the heavyweight champ.
Me.
But I couldn't do it all alone.
We.
Yeah, Young Money raised me. Grew up out in Daisy. Southside Jamaica. Queens and it's crazy. Cause I'm still hood. Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters. Sorry that you couldn't faze me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated. Best believe that when we done this moment, we'll be vindicated. Oh, no. This night just remind me of everything they deprived me of. Come on. Put your drinks up. Every time we link up, we done did everything they could think of. Greatness is what we wanna bring up. I could tell it's time.
swag matic, matic, mat, 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 mat.
Oh, you're fabulous.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me. And oh, happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
Exciting. I love your cake. It looks so delicious.
Yes. It used to be called the abortion cake, but my wife doesn't like that name. So I'm going
to
call it the Happy Fun My
Palin?
Little Pony one.
Huh? Are you married to Sarah Palin?
Yes.
That's too bad.
So how long have you been doing drag work?
Oh, I have been dressing since I was probably 16, 17. Like, you know, I was that townie that was like walking around dressed like Courtney Love in a small little town in the middle of Massachusetts. But I started my first club when I was 18 back in Northampton. And then I moved to Boston and all kind of took off from there.
Oh, that's really cool. And you work, you perform at Jocks. That's how I found you, actually.
I love performing at Jocks. I'm from there every Friday for the Misleading Ladies. And then I have my own show, The Cream of Laughter. And it's with me and my co-hostess, Katie Homophobia. And we're the second and fourth Wednesday of every month at Jocks. It's an amazing show. It's really funny. It's kind of disappointment if you really watch carefully. I drink a lot. But I perform all over the city. I mean, Jocks is really great, but there's so many great venues. I've been very,
really?
Very lucky and very blessed to be part of, like, a lot of, you know, great things. Like, I was part of Avalon and, you know, Access, and those are just legendary
right.
places. But, like, I'm performing at Machine Nightclub and...
That's right. I forgot about Machine. They do something there, too, right?
And I host an Underbar Hot Mess Sundays.
Oh, cool.
That's great. All over the city.
Oh, that's really cool. I'm glad that it's such... because for a long time, I think Jocks was the only place to do that sort of thing. I performed at Jocks downstairs. Oh, and upstairs, too. But totally different. I'm a poet. And I'm in bands and stuff. And so I did a couple of poetry performance art things. One downstairs and one upstairs.
Who was that with?
Rick Berlin.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I did a show with Rick Berlin. And then downstairs I opened up for a band called Guaranteed Catch and a bunch of friends of mine.
Mm.
But the day that we were doing Guaranteed Catch, I don't know if she's still there, but she did this song. We came upstairs and she was like, didn't catch her name. She was singing, "Let Me Smell Your Pussy." And it was the funniest fucking thing I've ever seen in my entire life. I was laughed so hard. My friend Bruce, who was with be on the show, he loves drag queens, and that's why I booked him to be on the show, and he called in sick, and I'm so bummed out because
we'll
totally wicked into it. Now, you know, do you know at what point did they go from female impersonators to drag queens?
There's always been a difference. It's always been like, you know, ever since it started, you know, it's been every element of drag has had its own category, you know. I just think that female impersonation has just been so popularized and mainstreamed by, like, RuPaul's Drag Race because, mm-hmm. you know, they're very fishy.
Right.
They fishy, meaning they look like real fish, like a real woman. Like, that's been the aesthetic. That's been, like, RuPaul's aesthetic. And I think it's opened a lot of, like, great doors for us. But, yeah, there are like, lots of different categories.
I'm a huge Drag Race fan.
Yeah. Who's your favorite this season?
Delta Work. Now, yeah. I missed this. Well, okay, so this is April, so they probably won whoever, but I missed this past Monday, so I don't know anything about it, so I have to catch it again, so I don't know what happened. I don't know who got kicked off. I'm hoping that, what's her name? The other big girl.
Oh, Stacy, Lane, Matthews. Brian, Matthews.
Yes.
Quarterly the third.
Yes. I have a secret suspicion she actually is a woman. And
you know, it's different for a lot of those, like, for the big girls. Like, yeah. I know for me, like, you can, you know, it's hard to cover them up. You know, people start thinking, oh, are you on hormones? Did you get breast implants? Did you do all these, like, crazy surgeries? I'm like, no, I'm a total boy during the day, like, total guy. Like, I love all my private parts, and they're readily available on Craigslist for a nominal fee. But, yeah, like, she gives you real fish.
Yeah.
she gives you real fish.
Who was your favorite on the show?
Yeah, she was one of my favorites. I really like, but Raja was great.
Raja's like, great.
I followed his work ever since he was on America's Next Top Model.
Oh, really?
He was the makeup artist on Top Model, and he worked with, you know, Tyra and all that. Again, I like his aesthetic.
Yeah, he's very different. Yeah. Like, he's got a whole different view of what he does. And yeah. I love it, because he's interesting, and he's not the same, and it's very cool. Who is the one that I hate now? I always forget her name. Carmen's a pain in the ass. And then
they're all really nice. Like, I've met all of them.
Oh, have you really?
They're all really nice. It's so funny. Like, it's just like, how is the show gonna portray you? And, like, yeah, you know, things like that. Like, if you're shy, you're gonna come off as a bitch.
Right.
You know, if you're shy, or, you know, the second season was probably, I think was better than this season. Like, my friend Juju, she was on second season.
Oh, Juju?
Season.
Really? Yeah, no way. I love Juju.
And they had a lot of great characters on that season.
Yeah, they did. That was Pandora Box.
Yes, Pandora. All those girls.
I love Pandora.
She's a riot. I just was on the Atlantis gay cruise, and she was on with us, and there was like freaking 10-15 drag queens on one ship. It was insane, with like 5,500 circuit boys running around, and their underwear was terrible. I'm trying to get a cocktail, awesome. And I'm like getting, like, you know, literally cocked.
Literally cocked.
Yeah, literally.
It's beautiful.
I love Salem. We're in gorgeous Salem. It's so beautiful out right now.
Yeah.
I was telling my friend I want to go to the museums. Amy Sedaris was in town like a couple months ago, and she's talking about she wanted to come see the witch statues, the witches at the museums, and they have the alcoholic hair.
Oh, right,
like,
yeah.
I want to go see those.
Yeah.
Gotta see the witches.
Don't forget to go see James next door.
Yes. Absolutely. I'm going to go take a look.
He's going to freak out.
Oh, my God. I can't wait.
James, I love you. All right, cool. Amazing. So we're going to do a second song.
Yes.
And there's a costume change, so we're allowed for that. So I think we're going to do something or not, but Miss Fena Barbitall will do it on the show. Thank you for being on my show.
Thank you. Happy birthday.
Someone taught me the haiku again, and I grew to love the haiku and be obsessed with it, and the haiku has become my life, so much so I wrote 1,000 haiku in 100 days. And this is an excerpt from that. It's called "The Best Pussy in Town." Not what you think. Miss Fifi Buzzball lounges out eating bonbons, fluffy drag queen king. Miss Fifi reclines in emerald green sequin dress, a big bad mama. 3 great day growth hidden, a bi-pasty pancake makeup, white trash fashion queen. Her hot pink bouffant, the finest in poodle cuts, indestructible. She's a good kitty from the wrong side of the tracks, pure as driven sludge. Wild woolly gal overshadows other girls, eclipsed by her girth. Dance floor shaking, a disco earthquake alert. Miss Fifi's dancing. Please welcome Miss Fena Barbitall for a second song.
This is the manifesto of Mother Monster. On Goat, a government-owned alien territory in space, a birth of magnificent and magical proportions took place. But the birth was not finite, it was infinite. As the wombs numbered, and the mitosis of the future began. It was perceived that this infamous moment in life is not temporal, it is eternal. And thus began the beginning of the new race, a race within the race of humanity, a race which bears no prejudice, no judgment, but boundless freedom. But on that same day, as the Eternal Mother hovered in the multiverse, another more terrifying birth took place, the birth of evil. And as she herself split into two, rotating in agony between two ultimate forces, the pendulum of choice began its dance. It seems easy, you imagine, to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good. But she wondered, how can I protect something so perfect without evil? It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. Put your paws up, 'cause you were born this way, baby. My mama told me when I was young, we're all on superstars. She rolled my hair, put my lipstick on, in a glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, 'cause he made you perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Give yourself prudence and love your friends, so we can rejoice the truth. In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, respect my youth. A different law is not. Yeah.
Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Whether you're broke or evergreen, you're black, white, beige, Chola descent, you're Lebanese, you're Orient. Whether life's disabilities left you outcast, bullied, or teased, rejoice and love yourself today, cause baby, you were born this way.
No matter gay, straight, or bi, lesbian, transgender life, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born to survive. No matter black, white, or beige, Chola or Orient, made, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born to be brave.
Thank you.
That was my diaphragm.
Oh, I want to thank our guest, Lydia's Carnival Sideshow, Miss Fena Barbitall. Woo! And the best birthday ever, motherfuckers! See you next week!